In this video, let us look at another project, dairy milk collection and payment system. So here we need to understand like how the milk will be collected in a collection center and what is the payment system. So now to understand this project, we need to know like how the milk will be collected in these centers. I'll just show you like, so initially the milk will be milked from the cow. They're collected in a vessel. So now maybe you have a system to collect using the machines. Okay, anyhow, this is the collection. Once the milk is collected, they'll take to the nearest collection center where it will be collected. And you can see that the testing will be taken place. Here is the lactometer. So we'll check the quality of the milk. Then there may be some more test. So they need to find out what is the fat percentage. There is also called as a SNF percentage in the milk. Based on these values, so the price can be fixed. Once milk is collected, then they'll send to the main center where it will be processed. Now, in this project, I'll just show you like what are the things we added, how do you make the complete project, and how do you show the payment, and how do you make the payment. Fine. So therefore here, as I shown in the pictures, so the main thing is, this is the milk center. This software is for the milk center or milk collection center. Collection center. So farmers will bring the milk here. So milk will have a different type, okay? So it may be buffalo milk, it may be cow milk, that is a different actually. And each milk have different qualities, you know, that they'll bring here. Here collections will be taken place. So based on the collections, day wise book will be maintained. So there are two times the collections, the morning collections and the evening collection. And what is the total liters? Price. Then the total. Here you can say date also will be there. So same thing will repeat in the evening also. Then for month or a week, we need to figure out the what is the total. Based on the total, we have to make the payment to the this farmer. This is the main concept of this project. I'll demonstrate and I'll show you like how this whole project works. So please write down all the forms design, and then you can write this project in VB or in C#. Or in Java or any other language you wish. So now let's come back to Visual Studio. I'm using Visual Studio 2019 here. So if you go to Help and About Microsoft Visual Studio, here you can see Visual Studio 2019. Right. And here is a Solution Explorer. If you don't find this here, you can go to View menu and then Solution Explorer. You can click on Solution Explorer. You'll get the Solution Explorer window. Here is a Solution Explorer window. You can see the forms here. So we have 15 to 16 forms are there here, and we given a name for each form. So generally when you try first time, the form 1, form 2, form 3 will be there. But instead of form 1, form 2, like you need to give the corresponding name. What exactly you want to do in this particular form. That is what very, very important. Now, if I take to flash screen, here is a flash screen. So we have one picture here. So this is the form. Now we change the background color to black color. Here you can see that there is a black color, and that is the property, and we change to black color. Okay. So here is a black color is selected, and also one more property called as a window state that is maximized. After that, we place the picture box here. So picture box you can find out in the toolbox. So in the toolbox you can see lot of objects are there. So search for picture box. So you can have a picture box here. So you drag and keep it on the picture box over there. The picture box will be there on the form. Now you need to link the picture. Okay. So you can prepare the picture using the paint. So let's say go to paint and then take the size, what size you want. Right. What is the background color you want to apply? Right, so then you can write the code over there, like so milk collection, dairy milk collection. Right, so what are the title you would like to give, so you can give the title corresponding to your project. So then add up some more pictures and then save. That file you need to call it over there here. So in order to call this, there is an image here. We need to browse and you have to import, and then you have to go to bin folder. Better to keep it in this folder. Therefore, it will be easy for you to access that picture. Okay, here it's outside. So we taken from the outside, but it is always better to keep it inside. If you bin folder, debug folder, keep the picture over here. So easy to access the picture. Anyhow, it's already linked. It is done. So next is a login form. So here you can go to login form. You can see there is a login form here. And here we have two text boxes, so text box 1 and text box 2. And if you look at the form, and in window state it's maximized. And then we are not changing the background color. You can always change the background color very easily. Go to background color and choose the color, what color you want. So that is always can be done. And here is the button, and we can change the button size. And you can replace this to this side and this one to this side. You can drag wherever you want. That is always possible. So next to that is the MDA parent. So here it is, MDA parent. Here it is a menu. So you need to add the menu from the toolbox. So there is a menu bar or menu strip. You need to add the menu strip, and then you have to, okay, it's selected already. Right. So in a menu, we have submenu here. So these are the forms. We need to link all the forms with this particular menu items. For example, if you go to area names, so you can say area name form MDA parent is equal to me. We want to maximize it, and we need to link to the MDA parent and area name form dot show. You have to show the form. So here is the area names. This form will be shown. Right, when you click new button, we clear all the text boxes, and we are enabling and disabling the buttons. And then when you click save, so we're going to save the record. So here is the code to save the record. So we'll check whether area name is already present or not. If it is already present, then we tell the user this record is already present. If not, then we'll not go into insert the record here. Okay, then there is a display record to display the records in the grid view. So this is the data grid view. Here we can display the records. Fine. So that's how we can design the each form, and then you have to write the code. So let me run this now. So first we'll take to the welcome screen. You can see there is a simple picture here. This is the welcome screen, and here is the title. You can change the title or you can change the picture, all possible. This you can see that the background just now it changed. Therefore, it's in different color now. Then if you push the wrong password, generally it won't accept, and it say that username password not correct. Therefore, you need to always to type the correct password. And it will come to the main MDA form. So MDA stands for multiple document interface. And here you can see that area names. You can say there is Vijayanagar. Let's say Golaralli. So what are the places comes under this area that you need to write down? Timing, I just put copy and paste, and then I created one more area name. Next is the fat range. So we already done fat average, fat good, fat max, fat minimum. So any other types you want to create, you can always do so in the this form. Fat is the one factor to set the price, and SNF is the another factor. Average, max, minimum. This is the another factor to set the price for the milk. Here is the milk price. There is no save and all. For each type, you can set the price over there. So these are 36.3 rupees. So if you take a fat good and then SNF max, then you can set the price. Let's say 39 rupees. Like this. So here is the customer detail. I have one customer. This is 1001, right? So likewise, you need to click new button, and then you have to create the customer. So this is the customer detail form. Next is the collection. So here you can see that is what time you are collecting, morning. Customer code, let's say 1001. So milk quantity, how many liters? Let's say 25 liters. Animal type is a buffalo. And the fat average, and then SNF average. Right, now it fetches 36.3 rupees, and totally 907.5 is the total price. When you save this, it's mean that the person is put the this many liters of milk to the diary. Now we can go to collection report and we can check it out, like how much is collected today. They show the list. So in case you have paid some advance and all that, we can enter it over there. Farmers need some advance because then they need to buy some food for cows, so they take advance, so that we can enter it here. And once you go to payment, so let's say every week we want to make the payment, so that time when you click it, you can see that this is a show the total amount, if any advance paid, and what is the balance amount. Okay, so therefore balance amount only more, so therefore you can go to collection and we can choose this customer. Let's say we'll put 150 liters animal type buffalo. Now I'll take fat good and this is max. Now you can see that it will fetch us 39 rupees. Okay, that's 5080. Now if you go to payment, and now we can see that we supposed to pay for this particular customer. Okay, so this is the total and then advance is paid, remaining amount. So cash paid or check paid means you have to specify the check. So here is one error, VDate.value. Okay, because it need to be formatted, it's not yet formatted here. So what I can do is I'll just take the cursor up, then I'll use the format function here. Format. So here is DD/MMMM, then YYY. So this is the date format, it should be in date format. Now if I run this, the record is saved. So next is the reports. You can see the customer list here. We can see all the customers. Then collection report, what are the collections done, that we can see it here. Then you have customer payment list. You can see the payment, what are the payment done. Then you have advance payment list. If any advance paid, that we can able to see there. Now this is because the date again. So date should be formatted. And sometime it works, but sometime it won't work. So here what you can do is bring the cursor up again. Then you go to from date, change to from date. And then again to date dot value, change this to date value. Okay. So now it's formatted. So once it's formatted, it will works because it is in the date format. So close it. Okay. So these are the forms which are there in this particular project. So please write down all these forms and the design also. And then you can try, as I told already, you can do this project in Visual Basic. You can do it in C#. You can do it in Java. You can do it in Android. So all possible. So this project is almost near to the real time. So the two way, one is dummy projects and one is the real time projects. So in case of dummy project, we say that very basic things will take. In real time, you'll take more and more details. This is near to, not exactly, but near to somewhat real time, because we calculate all the factors about milk, fat percentage, SNF percentage, and all these things. And all. Therefore, it's good actually. Right? So, therefore, please try. After write down all the page designs, you can always try this project to do it yourself. And then, if you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. You go to YouTube, and then if you search here iBlix tutorials, so you'll come to this page, and here is iBlix tutorials. You click over here, and generally you'll have the button here, subscribe button. Please subscribe. Then you go to the videos, and then you can see a lot of videos related to the Python, and different projects are explained. Please watch some project videos from the beginning, therefore you'll get a more idea. So because each time you need to do a different project, it should be a different idea, different concept should be there in the project. Therefore we are providing a lot of projects here. So watch some projects, so then you choose which one you like, and then how do you depend that, and what are the things are there in that, that we need to understand, that you need to learn more. So it definitely help you for your curriculum, definitely help you to get the job, and also it will help you to understand the project and gain the knowledge yourself. Fine. Anyway, I will come out with more videos soon. So please subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.